A Spring Song and a Later by James Whitcomb Riley by Algie Pug. She sang a song of May for me, wherein once more I heard the mirth of my glad infancy, the orchard's earliest bird. The joyous breeze among the trees, new clad in leaf and bloom, and there the happy honey bees in dewy gleam and gloom. So purely, sweetly on the sense of heart and spirit fell her song of spring, its influence, still irresistible, commands me here, with eyes a blur, to mate her bright refrain, though I but shed a rhyme for her as dim as autumn rain. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
A Spring Song and a Later by James Whitcomb Riley by Adrian Stevens. She sang a song of May for me, wherein once more I heard the mirth of my glad infancy, the orchard's earliest bird, the joyous breeze among the trees, new clad in leaf and bloom, and there the happy honeybees in dewy gleam and gloom. So purely, sweetly on the sense of heart and spirit fell her song of spring, its influence still irresistible commands me here, with eyes a blur, to mate her bright refrain, though I but shed a rhyme for her as dim as autumn rain. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
A Spring Song and a Later by James Whitcomb Riley by Bruce Kachuk. She sang a song of May for me, wherein once more I heard the mirth of my glad infancy, the orchard's earliest bird, the joyous breeze among the trees, new clad in leaf and bloom, and there the happy honeybees in dewy gleam and gloom. So purely, sweetly on the sense of heart and spirit fell her song of spring, its influence still irresistible, commands me here, with eyes a blur, to mate her bright refrain, though I but shed a rhyme for her as dim as autumn rain.
End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
A Spring Song and a Later by James Whitcomb Riley by Christopher Collins. She sang a song of May for me, wherein once more I heard the mirth of my glad infancy, the orchard's earliest bird, the joyous breeze among the trees new clad in leaf and bloom, and there the happy honey bees in dewy gleam and gloom. So purely, sweetly on the sense of heart and spirit fell her song of spring, its influence, still irresistible, commands me here, with eyes a blur, to mate her bright refrain, though I but shed a rhyme for her as dim as autumn rain. End of poem. This recording is in the public domain.
A Spring Song and a Later by James Whitcomb Riley by Garth Burton. She sang a song of May for me, wherein once more I heard the mirth of my glad infancy, the orchard's earliest bird, the joyous breeze among the trees, new clad in leaf and bloom, and there the happy honeybees in dewy gleam and gloom. So purely, sweetly on the sense of heart and spirit fell her song of spring, its influence, still irresistible, commands me here, with eyes a blur, to mate her bright refrain, though I but shed a rhyme for her as dim as autumn rain. End of poem.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.